right, in that first video, you'll see that that girl, she only wanted to come up and strive with me. And Philip was battling with words against another man, so he wasn't there to help me. So I just had to turn my back on her, but she was so filled with bitterness, and she said that all, I think she said that all, I'll have to play it back when I'll have to tell you what happened when I hear what she said, but as she walked away, she said that all religions are the same and something to that effect. And I said, no, there's only one name under heaven by which we can be saved, Jesus Christ. So we've only done like half an hour, and we've already come under attacks and persecution, but we just keep going on. Count it all joy.
That
well,
guy's name
it's not nice on people. We don't want to fall out with people. We don't want to have these contentions, but it's going to happen because the name of Jesus is powerful. Philip, please, sorry, what were you going to say?
I was going to say that guy's name was Bill. Gave him a little Bible anyway. Half said, but just pray for his salvation as well. Thank you. God bless you.
I'm going to stand up.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus, that whosoever believes on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Please be a whosoever and lay hold of your salvation. Be sure of where you're spending eternity, heaven or hell, and the choice is yours. Jesus said, unless you repent, you will never see the kingdom of heaven. Unless you repent, you will perish. God is not willing that any should perish.
Just wait until this dust cart has gone past.
Lay hold of your salvation. God loves you. We've come to tell you how much God loves you, but he's given you free will. He's given you a choice. He's given you a choice to either accept the free gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus Christ, or reject him. Please go to Jesus. Lay hold of your salvation. The Bible makes it expressly clear that we all have sinned and we all fall short of the glory of God. And that the wages of sin is death, the destruction of the soul for eternity. But the free gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus, to be a sacrifice, to shed his blood on the cross for the forgiveness of our past, present and future sins. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. And when you believe that in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. Save yourselves. You have a choice. This world is not all there is. This life is not all there is. There is a heaven and there is a hell. And your choice, your decision to accept or reject Jesus will determine where you spend eternity, heaven or hell, and the choice is yours. God wants all to be saved. The Bible, the Holy Word of God, says that God wants all to be saved. But he said also, unless you repent and change your mind, you would perish. Please, repent, change your minds from your unbelief and believe on what Jesus Christ has done for us on the cross. It's not about religion, and it doesn't matter what you have done. Jesus has promised that he would never turn anyone away who comes to him in truth. The Bible says we all have sinned. The wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Jesus shed his blood on the cross for the forgiveness of our past, present and future sins. He was buried and he rose again on the third day. That's the gospel. And if you will confess Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you'll be saved. That's how simple it is. It's not about religion. All these different religions tell you you've got to do a bunch of different religious things to make it to heaven. God is only asking that you believe on the name of his only begotten Son, Jesus, and what he did for us on the cross. To make it to heaven, you don't have to do anything. You have to believe on the one who's done everything. That is Jesus. Jesus took the penalty in full on the cross. He shed his blood for the remission of our past, present and future sins. He was buried and rose again on the third day. That's the gospel. And when you believe that in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. Save yourselves. Jesus Christ is coming any moment now. And Jesus shall tear open the heavens. The Lord Jesus Christ himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will be resurrected. The dead in Christ will rise first, and then all Christians which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with the dead in Christ to meet the Lord Jesus in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord Jesus. Lay hold of your salvation. Be part of this rapture. Be taken up to heaven in the rapture. Lay hold of your salvation. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. He is coming. Don't wait until you witness all these people suddenly vanish. Don't wait until you see all Christians disappear off the face of the whole world in the rapture. Be part of that rapture. Lay hold of your salvation. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved and taken up to heaven in the rapture. And then the world governments will come on the world stage and say that all the Christians were abducted by aliens. This is a strong delusion which God shall send. God shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe the lie, that they might all be damned, which believe not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life, and no man shall see the Father in heaven but through me. Jesus said, I am the door, by me if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Fear any man. Do not take the gamble that Jesus isn't who he says he is. The way, the truth, and the life, and the only name under heaven by which we can be saved and enter into heaven. Don't take the gamble that heaven and hell are not real, because they are. Hell is a place of outer darkness, where there is weeping and wailing, where there is gnashing of teeth, where the worms never die and the fire never goes out. Please don't wait until you're in there before you realise how real it is, because it will be too late then. Jesus said, unless you repent, you will all perish. Please, repent. Repent comes from the Greek word metanoia. It means to acknowledge your sin condition and then change your mind and believe on the one who paid the debt in full for all our sins on the cross. The gospel is that Jesus died for all our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried and he rose again according to the scriptures. That's the gospel, the simple gospel. And when you believe it in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. For with the heart, man believes and is justified, just as if he never sinned. And with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. That if you will confess the Lord Jesus with your mouth, say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. You have the choice. Heaven or hell, the choice is yours. Please, Jesus said, unless you repent, you will all perish. Please change your minds from your unbelief and believe on Jesus. Jesus was hanging on that cross, and his final words were, it is finished. The debt is paid in full, past, present, and future sins. He shed his blood for the remission of all our sins. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. And when you believe that and call upon Jesus, you will be saved with everlasting life, saved from going down to hell. God shall write your name in heaven. He will give you a place in heaven, because there is no other name under heaven given to us by which we can be saved. Jesus said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Be it any man, don't take the gamble that Jesus isn't who he says he is. He said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life, and no man shall see heaven but through me. Please, repent. Jesus said, unless you repent, unless you change your mind, you will perish. Please don't wait until you're in hell before you realize how real it is. It will be too late then. Please lay hold of your salvation. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved and your house. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord and unto our God, for he will abundantly pardon. Jesus promised, he said, I will never turn anyone away who comes to me in truth. Be humble enough to acknowledge that the words of the Bible are true. We have all sinned. The wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Be humble enough to say, well, yes, of course I have sinned. The Bible says we all have sinned. The wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord, for anyone and everyone who believes. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Be a whosoever, because you're not guaranteed your next breath. You're not guaranteed to be here tomorrow. When you draw your last breath, you will go into eternity. First, you will go to the judgment seat of God. And without Jesus Christ to have paid the debt for all your sins, you will not make it into heaven, but you will find yourself in hell. Please, change your minds. Repent. God is not asking you to get religious. He's only asking that you believe on the name of his only begotten Son, Jesus, and what he did for us on the cross. Jesus said, Jesus' own words were, if any man is ashamed of me and of my words, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he comes in the power of his Father with the holy angels. Do not be ashamed to go to Jesus and lay hold of your salvation. Be sure of your eternal destination. Because not one of us is guaranteed our next breath. When you draw your last breath, you will go into eternity. First, you'll go to the judgment seat of God. And without Jesus Christ, you will not make it into heaven, but you will find yourself in hell. Please, Jesus isn't asking you to get religious. He's only asking that you believe on what he did for you on the cross. He paid the debt in full. Jesus Christ shed his blood for the forgiveness of our past, present, and future sins. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. If you will confess Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. That's how simple it is to know you're going to heaven and not going down to hell. Please. Jesus said, unless you repent, you'll all perish. Unless you are born again, you will never see the kingdom of God. You are born again the moment you believe the gospel in your hearts, that Jesus was indeed sacrificed on the cross to shed his blood for the forgiveness of our past, present, and future sins. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. If you will confess Jesus as Lord, if you will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. That's how simple it is. There is a devil, the god of this age, who is deceiving mankind, whispering in the ears of mankind and saying to you, is God really real? Is Jesus really the only way I can make it to heaven and escape the damnation of hell? The devil, Satan, is deceiving the whole world and is trying to distract you from going to the one true God and his son, Jesus Christ, and laying hold of your salvation so that you will enter into heaven and escape the damnation of hell. The devil, Satan, he comes only to steal and to kill and to destroy. But Jesus Christ has come that we might have life and have it more abundantly, even everlasting life. The most important decision, the most important thing that any man must do when they come into this world is make sure of where they are spending their eternity, heaven or hell, and the choice is ours. Jesus wants all to be saved. All can be saved, no matter who we are, no matter what we have done. Jesus has promised, he said, I will never turn anyone away who comes to me in truth. But he said also, unless you repent, you all perish. Unless you change your mind from your unbelief and believe on Jesus, you will indeed perish. Please, go to Jesus. He will abundantly pardon. He will abundantly receive you. He will give you a place in heaven, and you will escape the damnation of hell, no matter what you have done. Because there is no other name under heaven given amongst men by which we can be saved. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life, and no man shall see the Father in heaven but through me. So go to Jesus. He said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. He shall go in and he shall go out and find pasture. The thief, Satan, comes only to steal and to kill and to destroy. And the devil is deceiving the whole world. The devil is distracting the whole world with whatever he can. With the media, with computer games, whatever he can do to grab your attention away from God. That is what the devil will do. He's come to steal and to kill and to destroy. And most people are just letting him rob them of their souls, of their eternal destination, heaven or hell. The choice is yours. Jesus said, unless you repent, you will all perish. Unless you repent, change your minds and believe on the Son of God and what he did for us on the cross, you will indeed perish. Please don't wait until you're in hell before you realize how real it is, because it will be too late then. Lay hold of your salvation now. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved and your house. May God bless each and every one of you. We haven't come here to condemn you. We haven't come here to judge you. We've come here to tell you how much God loves you and how simple it is to know how easy it is to be saved and enter into heaven by believing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus was crucified on the cross to shed his blood for the forgiveness of our past, present and future sins. He was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. And when you believe that in your heart, call upon Jesus, you will be saved. God bless you guys. God bless you with a sleeping bag.
Oh, dear me. Hardened hearts. So many hardened hearts. I thought that guy was coming up to give me some stick, but he came up to bash my knuckles like that. Never seen it like this before. It's a joke to most people, when really, it's the most important thing anybody can do in this life. Everything else, compared to laying hold of your salvation, is irrelevant. It really is. Not one of us is guaranteed our next breath. Without Jesus Christ, people will stand before the judgment seat of God they will not stand in the judgment. Without Jesus Christ to have paid the debt in full for all your sin, you won't make it into heaven and you'll find yourself in hell. And that's why we're here, to tell people the way that leads to heaven, Jesus Christ, who said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. He will never turn anyone away who goes to him in truth. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes on him should not perish in hell but have everlasting life. It's so simple. But I think the problem is I'm not judging all churches, but many of them have not reached out like they should be with the gospel and telling people how God loves all that he made and how simple it is to be saved. So I don't like to judge any church in particular. I'm not. There are a lot of good churches out there, but I feel like they're really let down society, many of them. I know there's some good churches as well. So anyway, I'm waffling on, guys. I'll upload this one and do another video. I'm not finished yet. Still some time left yet, and still people. God bless you.